welcome to Neutral Side Action, and we're just about ready for kickoff. It's time for the coin toss now, presented by Coke Zero. Real Coke taste, zero calories. Enjoy everything. The kicker's got the ball set up, and we're ready to get this thing started. Short kick. He didn't get a hold of that one. He's out to the 30. They'll bring him down at the 35. The quarterback brings his troops out onto the field for the first drive of the game. Gets out to about the 44-yard line. They run the option, and the pitch man will get credit for a 9-yard gain. It's second down now, and they're just a few feet away from that first down marker. It's the tailback. And he's level at the 48.
Nothing tentative on that run at all. He looked very determined and got the first down.
From the 48-yard line, second down. Fires across the middle, and he's immediately tackled. Tackled in the open field. And that's their third first down of the drive.
The defense needs to figure out a way to stop them, or else they're going to have no problem putting points on the board.
It's first down, and they'll be looking for 6 points here. Seven-yard scamper on the keeper. For the score.
That's what happens when you can win the war in the trenches down near the goal line.
He splits the uprights with the extra point. A 7-play, 66-yard drive, and it results in a touchdown.
Boy, this offense right now is just being physical, really controlling the line of scrimmage, and it's opening up some nice big lanes for the running back.
So the score now, 7-0. And he's taken down at the 27-yard line. The offense gets ready to take their first crack at it. He's tackled around the 36-yard line. Short yardage situation here. Second down and one. Gives it off. And he's tackled at the positive yardage. Decent gain there on the play by the running back, and that's enough for the first.
Solid 5-yard pickup. He was almost able to get to the secondary, but as it is, he still manages to move the sticks.
Pass complete and taken down immediately. From their own 46-yard line, it's second down. And he's tackled right around the 48-yard line.
Run a route short of the first down. That just baffles me every time I see that.
Looks like they're going to go for it on fourth down. He's at the 40. And they make the stop at the 26.
Terrific run in a crucial spot. The big key was the offensive line giving the ball carrier room to get upfield.
From the 21-yard line, second down. Inside the 10, and he gets the touchdown. Here comes the kicker to try to tie this game up. He hits the PAT. So an 8-play, 74-yard drive, and that's good for a touchdown.
Brad, not only did they put points up on the board, but I think it's the way they did it. Now, that could be demoralizing for a defense.
We're even at 7 in this one. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. And this one's a short kick. This is a fun game, and I think we're going to see a lot of interesting football before it's over. Gets rid of it quickly, and that was almost picked. The defense really missed a golden opportunity there.
That's what separates a good player from a great player. When you have a chance like that, you need to take advantage of it.
From their own 39-yard line. Second down. Quick throw, and down he goes at the 48-yard line.
What impresses me so much is the guy's vision. He read the coverage perfectly to find his man for good yardage.
Takes it up the middle for a nice run. First and 10. Ball on the 47.
I got number 18. I got some 18. Man. Four, three, and eight. Closer, 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 closer.
Caught with room to work. Couple of yards there.
Tonight's play by the defense to shut down all the lanes, so this halfback wasn't able to make anything happen on that play.
So at the end of one, we get a tie game at 7-7. We're all tied up, and more action coming, hopefully, here in quarter number two. Tackled after a decent pickup. It's third down, and they're about 2 yards shy of the sticks. Brought down right around the 32-yard line. Bring him down at at about the 35. And that play was snuffed out from the get-go.
You're right. It's a delayed handoff to the tailback, and the defense wasn't fooled at all there.
Second down, 13 yards to go. Ball on the 35. Zips it to the tight end. Tackle made around the 23-yard line. So far this drive, the defense has been unable to stop them on third down. Pickup of a yard for the tailback.
That's a deal. That makes us work on issues.
They're trying to stop the run here with a goal line defense. He's taken down around the 22-yard line.
I'm not going to fault that decision. It was definitely a first down that they could have picked up. You want to be aggressive early on, even if it doesn't always work out.
Really a great stop by the defense. This will go down as one of those critical plays. This is the point in the game where you don't want to make any mistakes that give the other guys a reason to feel more confident going into halftime. He makes it out to maybe the 23-yard line. Second down and nine to go. Ball on the 23-yard line. He's taken down at the 43. To get the first here on second down. He makes his way out to about the 35. Down, 10 to go. Ball on the 24-yard line. He gets hit out of bounds around the 11-yard line.
Before it got started. That was just a case of the offensive line getting beat at the snap of the ball.
From the 14-yard line, it's second down. And he carries the ball for a nice gain. And this is the ninth play of the current drive. The quarterback in the gun, empty backfield, five wide receivers in the formation.
You know, this is just amazing. You spend 6 days planning as a defensive coordinator for one guy, and then you get the other quarterback. So now what happens?
So they're going to go for it here. Watch out for a pass play when you're in a goal line D. Touchdown. He's
got two touchdowns on the ground today.
That was just an excellent individual effort to find the end zone.
He makes the PAT. Looks like they're ready for the kick. He's out to the 30. And he makes it out to about the 34-yard line. In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. Setting up blockers, or running back's got it on the screen. He's tackled at the 38.
Usually a defense will look to kind of have a feel based on the tendencies and research that they have done throughout the week to be able to see when a screen might be coming. But truly, you have to be able to get your eyes on the quarterback and just sense the timing's a little bit different. Wow, that offensive lineman let me get by a little bit too easily. And that should be, something needs to tip the hand of the offense to let you know that a screen is coming.
The quarterback in the gun with five receivers. Deep pass to the end zone, and he went way up, and he's got the interception.
I just don't think he saw the defender, and he threw the ball right at him. That's what happens when you focus on one guy. You get tunnel vision.
From their own 18-yard line, first down.
This is smart, efficient play call. You don't need to make the highlight reel on each play.
Well, we've played a half of football. The Bearcats with a touchdown lead.
Glad to have you with us in the studio for the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Reese Davis and David Pollack here, completely locked in on that first half. A tight, hard-hitting, low-scoring affair.
Great
this is right.
You can say it like it is.
This is right in your wheelhouse, Pollack. I mean, this is exactly in your comfort zone.
No, absolutely. I mean, you like to see people flying around. You like to see defenses dictating to offenses and make them play on our terms. And it's fun to watch. It's something that every great defense prides themselves on tackling. You know, you didn't see very many missed tackles in the first half that led to big plays. And try to limit those big plays. And when they do get down towards the red zone, make people kick field goals. And that's how you see dominant defenses year in, year out. And that's what we're seeing today.
That's going to do it for David and me here in the studio. Time to get you back to the game. Brad and Kirk ready to take you home in the second half.
All right, Reese and David, thanks, guys. Second half action just about ready to start here. He's out to the 30, and he makes it out to about the 31-yard line. So we're just about ready to return to action. Second down now, and they need about 4 yards to pick up the first. He'll keep it on the ground again. Makes it out to about the 50. Tight end, and he's tackled at about the 45.
He ran a good route there and was able to pick up yards underneath the coverage.
It's okay to move the ball in small portions because it relaxes the offense and can open things up for the big play.
It's second down, 5 to go. Ball on the 45. Incomplete, trying to get it to his receiver. The defense got some pressure and forced a bad pass.
I think they've been a little bit more aggressive here with their pass rush, and that time it paid off with an incompletion.
They spread the field in the gun with 5 wide receivers. Makes the catch, and he's got nowhere to go. They got a little bit there, but less than a yard.
And a great job of not allowing this explosive freshman to do anything with the ball after the catch.
They're trying to pin them deep with a solid punt right here. This one will go into the end zone, and they'll bring it out to the 20. This deficit can be easily overcome, sure. But they have to be thinking if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense. Runs it left for a decent gain.
That brings them second and 5.
From their own 25-yard line, second down. Scrambling around, slides down to the ground.
That makes it first and 10.
Nice run, and he's brought down.
That's good for a gain of 5 yards. That brings him
second down and 5. Ball on the 35-yard line. Up the middle for a nice gain. His way to the 49-yard line.
That'll make it second and
so it's second down, and they're only about a foot away from picking up the first down. He's on the run. Makes it to the 34. Second and 11 coming up now. Ball on the 35-yard line. Boy, was he drilled as he let go of that football.
Yeah, he's going to feel that one tomorrow.
It's the 9th play of the drive. Concentration to pull it in.
Well, this guy really showed some giddy up getting down the field for a big game.
That makes it first and 10.
From the 16-yard line, first down. The stop at the 2. Here's the 11th play of the drive. All the big boys are on the field now. Both teams have their big sets out there. He dives and he'll be marked down.
from the 1 yard line. It's second down. And they'll score.
That was a very good all-around effort. The running, the blocking, the entire package. A well-deserved score.
They'll line up for the extra point in an attempt to tie the game. He splits the uprights with the extra point. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. He's out to the 30. Tackle made the 42-yard line. You don't want to squander any possessions, but maybe now's the right time to dip into your bag of tricks a little. Think about some gadget plays to catch the defense napping. 1 yard loss for the halfback. Second and 10, ball on their own 41. Quarterback all by himself in the backfield with five wideouts. Quick pass. Tackle right around the 50. They go to the back, and he's hit immediately in the backfield.
You know, the offensive play calling wasn't clicking on that last drive, and their execution was lacking.
Here's the punt. No, they're going to throw it. He wants it all. Can't pull it in. So at the end of three, we're deadlocked right now at 14. Into the fourth quarter now, and we're back to the action. We might have overtime in the back of our minds, but down on the field, that hasn't occurred to anyone. They want to end this thing in regulation. They go with the run. He tackles him for a loss. From midfield, second down. They'll line up with five wide receivers. And he snags that one. How about that play?
That's a good pickup there. He just dropped back and delivered a nice throw.
Third down, and they need to get it down to the 39. Throw to the right to his fullback, and down he goes around the 38-yard line.
Sack him, the pressure was still enough to force a bad pass. If you can get in there and disrupt the pocket, then the quarterback is going to have a tougher time getting the ball to his playmakers.
Second down and 10 to go. Ball on the 38-yard line. He's pushed out of bounds at the 42. Delivers. Almost picked off.
You don't want to ever give your opponent a second chance, but that's exactly what they did by not making that interception.
He'll try to knock this punt down inside the 20. 20-yard line. This is when things get a little prickly. You need your playmakers to really come through here. He's taken down at about the 31. First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 31-yard line. Down around the 32-yard line.
That brings up second and nine.
Brad, I just think this quarterback's got to do a much better job of being able to read that defense and make quicker decisions. And especially when the defense starts to get pressure, you've got to either get rid of that football or check it down or take off and run with it.
Throws quick to the receiver and it falls incomplete.
Number 80 was the intended receiver on the play. That'll bring up fourth and nine.
Certainly they don't have the return on here. They'll bring him down at the 43. We might have overtime in the back of our minds, but down on the field, that hasn't occurred to anyone. They want to end this thing in regulation. Less than 3 minutes in the game. And he tackles him hard at the 43-yard line. From the 43-yard line, it's first down.
Same play as the one before, and they got a good completion and a nice game.
He's got it with room to run.
These short, effective passes are going to help the quarterback's confidence.
That brings him second and five.
From the 27-yard line, second down. Pressure coming. He gets rid of this one.
Great job by the defense of getting after that quarterback. And right now, I think they've got him with some happy feet. He appears to be a bit rattled.
Hands. Fourth down. It looks like they're going to try for the long field goal. Kicks up. And he nails the long field goal. And that gives them the lead.
I know that I call kickers head cases, but this kid isn't one. It's like he doesn't even feel the pressure.
Looks like they're ready for the kick. And he got all of this one. Great kick. He's to the 20. He makes it out to maybe the 23-yard line.
Right, this has been a great game to watch. A lot of competitive spirit out there. The offenses seem to be going up and down the field. Back and forth we go. I think the winner will be which defense can make that pivotal stop to secure a victory.
You know this is a real crucial time in the game. It could still go either way. Less than 2 minutes in the fourth quarter.
Here by this quarterback of sitting in until the last second trying to make a play downfield only to have this defense get to him. He's got to do a better job maybe feeling things out a little bit, but at least he has the awareness and a toughness to sit in that pocket.
Hand off inside and he's quickly brought down. It's third down and long, and losing by a possession, I would expect them to have to go to the air. Well, a lot of frustration by that offense, but you've got to give the defense credit for coming up with a stop in this quarter in a game this close. He's in trouble. He's got it out to his tight end. Well, you can talk about offense all you want, and they were good today, but the defense was better. They come up with a play of the day, and that'll lead to the victory. Here we are late in the fourth quarter in a very important and a very tight football game. And who's going to come to the forefront? We'll see who's got the most leadership. And he's tackled after positive yardage. The Bearcats taking their first time out of the half. Second down and six. Ball on the 37. They bring him down in the backfield.
When this guy gets his arms around the ball carrier, I don't care who it is, he's not getting away.
We have less than a minute to go. They'll drop him for a loss. Seems as though they didn't want to risk stopping the clock on an incompletion, so they kept it on the ground. Fourth down now.
And this is when you have to overpower the defense to keep moving the ball. That time, they didn't succeed.
Calls for the fair catch. Well, this is the chance. Late in the fourth quarter, they're behind, but they've got an opportunity now to come back and win it. Defense goes with the extra defensive backs as the offense comes up five wide. Throws completely, stopped immediately. Spikes the ball. From their own 15-yard line. It's third down. Quick out to his receiver. And bring him down right around the 26-yard line. Down again. Catches it, and he's looking for more. And they push him out at the 49.
This passing game can be very effective if you don't get enough pressure on the quarterback. They use their personnel well and can be very tough to defend.
First and 10. Ball on the 49-yard line. Five wide. Once and all, going deep.
That could have been a huge shift in momentum if they were able to hold on to that one.
Wow, that was close.
And this is the eighth play of the drive. He chucks it downfield. No, incomplete. Third down now, and they need to get it inside the 41. One last play, folks. It's time to find out how far he can throw it and see if this game becomes one of the all-time greatest. Here we go. He goes downtown. Incomplete. And this one comes to an end. Our final count in this game, the Grizzlies 17, the Bearcats 14. That brings this broadcast to a close. For EA Sports and Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler. We'll see you soon for another edition of NCAA Football 14.